We found some old plots in the Sierra that we have measured over time, plots that were measured in the old growth condition prior to a lot of fire suppression, prior to logging. We found not only that over time the forest has increased in density, but it also gave us some insight into how forests used to be structured. They were composed of groups of trees, interspersed with gaps, lots of heterogeneity. We decided to initiate a new study where we were trying to develop a thinning treatment that was an attempt to create some of that spatial pattern that we used to see in historical forests. And we're comparing that to a more evenly thinned forest and also against an unthinned control area. What we found is trees tend to be in groupings of 2 to 5 or even 20 trees and of varying density, varying species composition. There's just a huge diversity in structures. And we think that structure made the forest resilient to fire, and it probably also made it resilient to bark beetles. The heterogeneity in these stands made them resilient to fire. That variation provides discontinuity of fuels through that stand, so that fire can never really build up a head of steam coming through that forest. This is a slab of wood out of our Stanislaw Tuolumne experimental forest, and it illustrates the frequency of fire that we used to see in the Sierra Nevada. This particular piece of wood registered 32 different fires, and you can see that a lot of these fires are as little as 4 years apart. This particular area, it burned prior to 1889, it burned about every 6 years, and then no fires since 1889. These really frequent fires used to keep the regeneration at bay, thinned the forest out, and so in the absence of fire, the forest has obviously become a lot denser. We just wrapped up our measurements for this last year, and this forested area is just being hit right now with the bark beetle mortality that's sweeping the Sierra. And what we found is that areas that had been previously thinned are experiencing a significantly less mortality compared to areas that are unthinned.